Hello, my dragonfly friends. I am doing a coaster mix and match. It's for a commission piece. Somebody I know wants some coasters, so that's what I'm doing. They're taped on the back. Normally, I don't show you how I mix my colors because I figure there's so many other people out there that do the same thing that I don't really need to, but I'm going to in this instance. Today I am using mixed pour. I'm using the thin. I like this stuff because especially when I do flip cups, which I will be doing on the coasters, the transparency is gorgeous and the lines are perfect. Once you clean your sides, the composition stays. It does not fall off. And when I use flow trowel sometimes, it has a tendency to do so. So I am a big fan of mix. Not that I don't use other pour mediums on occasion, but I do really like the mix. I'm not going to do any gack or anything in my mixing today just because they're coasters. It's not a large canvas, so I don't generally get splitting or crazing or anything like that on the smaller things. I already mixed up my white just to save some time, and that's the Artist Loft white, my go-to standard white generally. Put that over to the side. Today I am going to do pink and purple with some gold in it. I'm going to do the Pebeo Rose Azo with the DecoArt Extreme Sheen, just a touch of this in the pink tourmaline, just because this is transparent and I want the pink to show up. I am also doing the Pebeo, let's see, it's the dark cobalt violet hue with the DecoArt Pearl Dioxazine Purple. So just a touch of these little tiny shimmery things. She wants it super shimmery and glitzy and everything. I do already have some 24 karat gold deco art mixed up in here just to do a little bit of an accent. Other than that, I'm just gonna mix a little bit with mix. You don't have to use a whole bunch of paint. It generally doesn't take too much for that to show up. We're just gonna do a touch. Just a tiny, tiny bit. And I like to use the silicone just because it's squishy. And I can get to the bottom and scrape the sides and everything really, really well. You can tell that the colors are gonna be lighter than in the bottles, but when this dries, it's gonna dry darker. And I always try to scrape my sides really good. Bottom. Corners, get those really pretty pigments to shine through. So, I don't know if you can see that. It's still mixing up. You can tell, see the little clumpies in it? So it does take some time, but once you get it all mixed up, very, very pretty. Usually I take my time mixing and then usually I will let them rest for a little while, but because I'm filming and it's coasters, just because there's some air bubbles when you mix it. I'm not necessarily mixing gently, just to make sure that all those pigments come together. So I don't know if you can see the consistency. Very, very light consistency. I don't know if you can see the white on film, but it's the same consistency, very fluid. Okay, and we'll mix up pink. Whenever you're using the Extreme Sheen or any of the DecoArt pearls or the metallics, make sure to give a good shake, mix them up really well so that all that stuff that settles at the top gets mixed in. Okay, Poopy. Hold down. Come on. You can come in with Mama. Come on. You sit. Come sit. Come here, Poopala. Sorry, we always call our puppy funny little names. His name is Griffin, and he is about 6 months old. He's just about fully grown. He's a weird mix of... We adopted him. We kind of did a rescue with him. He's mostly Chihuahua, surprisingly, and then a Border Collie, and then a Labrador mix. But what he really does look like is a miniature Golden Lab. He's beautiful, but he's half the size. And he's just about grown, so he's not going to get much bigger. So he just looks like a half-size lab. But he's been really good. I got him to be a support dog for my kids. We'll see how that ends up being. It's going to take quite a bit of training. Okay, so here's the pink. Same consistency. And it's so pretty. Also wanted to mention too that I have some of these unicorn spits. I don't know if any of you have used them before. They're pretty cool, but the glitz in it is just like extreme glitz. And so I'm just gonna use these as accent, just like with the gold. I'm gonna just drizzle or do a line or something to make sure that there's not too much, but they will look pretty with all of that. Okay, so forgive me if you hear the kiddos in the background. The boys don't have summer school anymore, so they're already bored this morning. You might be hearing them, twin brothers, converse loudly often, so please forgive me. So I'm gonna just do like a set of flip cup. And I'm gonna do different combinations, I guess you could say, as to the order, maybe. Like, let's with this one. Let's go ahead. I'm gonna put my gloves on before I forget, because I always forget, and I already have a little bit of paint on my hands. Birthday gloves. And I'll put a little bit of white first, just a little bit, and then I'm going to do purple, maybe a little bit more white, and then the pink. in it. Get it all down to the bottom. And while that's kind of waiting, I'm going to go ahead and do the next cup. So this time I think I'm going to start with purple. I'll do a heftier amount because I'm only going to do the three layers in this one. And then the white. Over, and we'll pop this up and lip it. Let that kind of sit for a minute. With mix, you can use your torch to pop bubbles. It's pretty awesome. That's why I like to use it more than with house paint, because you can't really, or you're not supposed to really, use a torch. Here's my thing for carrot cake. It's a little bit thicker, but I'm just doing it as a drizzle. So just something like that. I don't like it with just the gold. Maybe I won't use the unicorn spit. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Okay, so we'll go ahead and do this. And we can start on this cup. I'm gonna do the pink first this time. Those are looking pretty. I might not need to use the unicorn spit, but we'll see. Sounds funny to say that, but okay. do this one. And then in this cup, let's do white, purple, and we'll put the pink right on top of it and see what we get. Gloves are really big. Okay, let's see what we get. I think with these two, I'm gonna wait to do the drizzle after I stretch it out and see. I kinda like how it's blended in. See some goobers. Much on this one. Just design with it. Okay, I like that one a lot. All right, let's do the last one. I don't know, what do you guys think? Do you like putting it on before or after? I like how it blends in, but maybe it spreads out too much. You can always come back and add some more paint. See what we get. Oh, jeez, hold on. Sorry, when I go silent, I'm thinking. So, I'm just trying to make it look good and pretty. Kind of like that. Alright. So, those are my coasters. I hope you liked watching today. And I'm sorry I didn't use any of the unicorn spit, but I think it would add too much, and I like the way that they look now, and the transparency is just gorgeous, and the blending of the gold, it can be bossy, but right now it's being nice. What I'll probably end up doing is taking some of the 24 karat gold and doing the sides, painting the sides before I resin it, because I think that'll add a lot to it. Let me know what you think. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed me talking through this one, or when I wasn't holding my breath when I was talking. Let me know what you think. I hope you all have a great day, and keep your creations coming, and keep soaring when you're flying with those imaginations of yours. I hope you have a great day. Bye.